A sellout crowd here at Legion Field in Birmingham, Alabama on the third Saturday in October. I'm Mark Jones along with Tim Brent. We are just awaiting the opening kickoff. Tennessee and their head coach, Philip Fulmer. He comes in with a record of 9-1. He won the last four games of last year when he took over, and he has done a fine job this season. Meanwhile, on the other sideline, Gene Stallings, hey, all he did last season was lead his team to a national championship, 36-6 overall. Here's a look at the standings in the SEC's Eastern Division. Tennessee with a record of 3-1, a critical game for them, Tim.
It really is, because Tennessee lost to Florida. They've got to win here today. Florida right now beating Auburn, so this game is huge for the Volunteers.
Meanwhile, in the Western Division, Alabama 3-0, 5-0 overall. Auburn not eligible for the title. They are 4-0, though.
Yeah, see, that's huge also, and Alabama obviously in the driver's seat. That championship game will be here December 4th in Birmingham again, and it looks like Alabama will be involved.
Alabama won the opening toss but decided to defer. They put their defense on the field. Michael Proctor will kick it for Alabama. Back deep, Garner and Williams for Tennessee.
Let me post this warning right away. Tennessee has speed and plenty of it.
This stadium is a sea of crimson. There's a smattering, though, of orange. The opening kick. To the 8-yard line, it's Williams. Billy Williams hit at the 28. And there's a look at the starting quarterback, Heath Shuler, a Heisman Trophy candidate. A look at his career statistics. 29 touchdown passes thrown so far. He's on pace to break the school record. Look at the backs and the receivers. Garner and Phillips in the backfield. The receivers, as Tim mentioned, very fast, very dangerous. Faulkner and Fleming. And up front on the offensive line, Lehman, Mays, Miller, Smith, and Ratliff. Young. A very young line. First and 10 on the first play of the game. They float the flanker screen for little or no gain. That swarming Bama defense.
We talked about Tennessee throwing on first down. They did it. Did not fool anybody on this defense.
A look at the front for Alabama. Jeremy Nunley, James Gregory, and Albert Brown. The linebackers led by Lemanski Hall, the Butkus Award nominee. Rogers, Walters, and Brown on the other side. And in the secondary, a very good group led by Antonio Langham.
With the ends, John Copeland and Eric Curry going to the NFL, everybody thought this defense would be average. Has not been the case.
They lost a yard on first down. It's 2nd and 11. Shuler rolls out. Completes the pass up to the 33-yard line to Billy Williams, the junior college transfer. Tim, what about the Tennessee story? What do they have to do?
Well, we talked about throwing on first down, and we've already seen that, and I think we'll see that throughout the game. They do have to protect Shuler, and he has to spread the load, get everybody involved, so he doesn't carry the burden on his shoulder. Sacked 5 times last year. Alabama defense, they've got to get the pressure on him again, and they have to force turnover. They've got a lot of interceptions, but they don't have the fumbles they had last year, and that's what the coaches are trying to do, force the fumbles.
3rd down and 6 for the Vols on their opening possession. Shuler back to pass over the middle for Williams, and it's picked off. Willie Gaston. And he's down to the 44, tackled by Phillips, but Alabama makes the first big play of the ball game.
Interceptions this year coming into the game. Here's number 12. It's Gaston, the nickelback. He's back in the midfield playing free safety. Just reads his eyes all the way. Actually, he was beaten on the play, but came underneath. The ball was a little bit underthrown, intended for Garner down the middle.
Alabama with very good field position. A look at Gaston, who made the interception. He's their nickelback, and he's made some big plays for them this season. Palmer in motion. They'll move him around, and he gets the opening carry. Up and down at the 47-yard line. The starting quarterback for Alabama is Jay Barker. All he's done since he's been a starter is win 22 straight games. The backs and the receivers. Sherman Williams, number 20, has had a string of consecutive 100-yard-plus games. The wide receivers, Kevin Lee and David Palmer, they will move him around a lot, though. Up front, a very seasoned and experienced offensive line. Hammond, Clay, Shields, Stevenson, and Patterson.
Boy, Alabama, at least one interception in 14 straight games.
Second down and 8. The give is to the fullback, Tarrant Lynch. He runs it over the right tackle, and he's down at the 47 by Horace Morris. A look at Tennessee defensively. They are exceptionally young up front and a little bit light as well. Morris, Yudkowsky, Bonham, and Wilson. The linebackers have been shaken up just a little bit this week. Scott Galen replaces George Kidd. He's joined by Ingram and Talley. And in the secondary, Jenkins and Davis on the corners, Victor Brown and Jason Parker, the safeties. Third down and 7 on Alabama's opening possession. Parker. And it's short at the 40-yard line. Intended for Chad Key. So Tennessee's defense answers, and Alabama will have to punt.
Key should have made that catch, and he knows it. It would have been a difficult catch, but it certainly was there and catchable.
It almost appeared, Tim, as if he lost his footing as he was about to plant and make the catch.
Rain last night, rain this morning. The field is wet.
Brian Deal into punt. He's standing on his own 33. Back deep, Sean Summers for the Vols. And this one will bounce into the end zone. Tennessee, when we come back, will have the ball on its own 20-yard line, a 53-yard boot just underway in Birmingham. Back at Legion Field, we are just underway in the first quarter. Alabama and Tennessee scoreless. The Vols with the ball. Auburn, meanwhile, trailing Florida 27-14. That game at halftime. Remember, Tennessee has to hope that Florida loses and Tennessee wins this afternoon. Garner, the lone back on first and 10. He gets the carry for a gain of about 2. Of course, Alabama has won the last 7 in this series, Tim.
Yeah, we talked about that mark at the outset. Look at this now. Go down to the second line. The first quarter scoring 76-10. Tennessee's been outscored. Turnovers are big, 22-10. And we've already seen that. Alabama with the interception early by Gaston. At least one interception in 14 straight games. Rushing yards heavily in favor of Alabama.
Second down, 9 to go. 3 wide receivers for Shuler. They run the quick hitch, and that'll be a loss. The pass was caught by Billy Williams, tackled by Antonio Langham. Back to New York now and John Saunders.
Mark, Michigan State against Ohio State, and the Buckeyes do it again. Bobby Hoying, 22 yards to Joey Galloway. 6 plays, 67 yards. 6 games, they've scored on the opening drive in each of those 6 games. 7-0. Back to you, Mark.
Take a look at this play from the end zone. It's an isolation to the flanker. They try to set up the screen by bringing the lineman out. Langham wants no parts of it. He beats the blocker to the ball. Great support. Very quick read.
Shuler off to an inauspicious start. He's 3 of 4 with 1 interception for just 2 yards. Passing. And this is where he can hurt you. Shuler, though, tackled at the 27-yard line. He's a dangerous runner. He was brought down that time by Michael Rogers. Shuler, the third-rated passer nationally, Tim.
Yeah, he can throw, he can run. He's an exceptional ball handler. He was the SEC Player of the Week in Week 4, but right now they're all over him. Looks like Rogers is the spy. He's following him everywhere he goes.
He didn't get the first down, and now Tom Hutton is into punt for Tennessee. Let's see what he does in punting it to or away from David Palmer. Palmer's going to get a chance to return it at the 42. Palmer downed at the 48-yard line, a 31-yard punt, 9 on the return, and there's a flag down on the play.
This is going to be unsportsmanlike conduct. The easy way out here is the offset penalties. Hit them both. It's going to go against Tennessee.
There's a look at our officiating crew, led by Rom Gilbert.
Let's see if we can pick it up. Take the end of the play here. Good coverage by Tennessee, but look at the right hand of your screen up to the face.
It's a backup fullback, Mario Brunson, that time that was leading the extracurricular activity.
But it was Darryl Blackburn, 44, that went to the head.
Alabama gets a little help on the play, and now we have another flag. A little motion on the left side of the line.
You know, for Mario Brunson, that's a mental mistake that cannot happen in a game of this magnitude. Emotion gets in the way of concentration, and that was a terrible mental mistake on his part.
You will see that happen, though, in a game of this magnitude.
I'll tell you what, you put Alabama on that side of the field, shorten the field offensively that much, and it's like running downhill.
Second down and 15 after the infraction. This is Sherman Williams. Tackled by James Wilson.
That was first and 15. It's five straight 100-yard gains for Sherman Williams. That's a school record. He's on a pace to go well over 1,000. He's the leather lugger. He's the guy that carries the football most of the time.
At Mobile, Alabama, averaging 5.5 yards a pop. The ball on the 38-yard line of Tennessee. Parker on the waggle. They set up a screen to Lynch. Tarrant Lynch near the first down marker at the 24-yard line before he's tackled by Reggie Ingram.
Well-designed play, outstanding execution. First, they pull the right guard Stevenson to get some protection for Barker. Freeze it right there. Here's his protection on that side. Now clear it and roll it. Now he'll throw back to the backside. Now watch the block that Roosevelt Patterson gets on. Not a big block. Here comes Patterson out of the left of your screen, number 77. Takes out the corner. Bingo. Move the chains.
Good ball handling that two time by Jay Barker as well. He's not flashy, Tim, but he gets it done.
They needed 14 yards. They got 14 yards and an inch. I tell you this, now they're down in the red zone, or what I like to call the green zone. This is the money area, and Alabama has scored 21 of 25 times inside the 25.
The model of efficiency, 9-19 to play in the first quarter. Alabama on its second possession of the ballgame. Lynch and Williams in the offset eye. Sherman Williams.
Oh!
Bounces off one like a bowling ball. Down to the 9. He was pushed out of bounds after a 16-yard pickup by Jason Parker, but man, he lowered the hat on somebody.
I'm going to tell you, Sherman Williams is 5'10", 193 pounds. Watch what he does to Victor Brown, number 16, the strong safety. Here it comes, folks. Bang! Get him out of my face. Get outside. Brown was supposed to deliver the blow. Instead, he took it.
The ball on the Tennessee 8-yard line. Parker on the toss to Williams, trying to get to the corner. Cuts it up inside and is down to the 7-yard line. A pickup of one on that play.
Well, how about Alabama? I mean, we talked about their defense with Curry and Copeland gone and how the defense has stepped up and been outstanding. But offensively, they lose Derek Lassick, who's playing with the Cowboys, and Martin Houston. They're gone. So now Sherman Williams steps up, and he's going to go over 1,000 yards.
There is a lot of speed on this team.
This is what we just talked about, Mark. They get down this far, they make you pay.
Second down and 7. Williams down to the 4. Tough going in that red zone, or green zone, as you like to call it.
Tell you what, he's only 5'10", and I think that's giving him an inch. But it gives him that low center of gravity. He's almost 200 pounds. Well, he knows the difference between come here and sick him. He really delivers a punch.
Williams had a fumble last week against Arkansas, so he was really holding onto the ball tightly that time when he was tackled. Third down and goal. Going to the fade pattern for Lee, incomplete in the end zone.
Bounce right off Ronald Davis's helmet.
Davis saying, not here, not in my neighborhood.
Oh, he got a break. He got a break. He didn't even see that ball coming. It hit the back of his helmet. Ronald Davis, the corner. They go to the fade. Go ahead and roll it. Watch this now. He locks in. He's in man coverage. All of a sudden they say, hey, if I'm even, I'm leaving. Lee thinks he's got this, but instead it hits the back of the helmet of Ronald Davis.
A 22-yard field goal attempt by Michael Proctor, and it's good. So the Alabama Crimson Tide pay off in the green zone. They lead 3-0. Alabama just putting a field goal on the scoreboard. The scoring drive, 7 plays, 30 yards, using up a little over 2.5 minutes on the clock. And once again, Alabama scores first in this series.
You don't think that unnecessary roughness penalty was big now? Cost them 3.
Proctor's kick at the goal line. That's Garner. Coming right down Main Street and tackled at the 24-yard line. So Heath Shuler comes in to lead the offense for the 3rd time in the game. They had an interception on the first series and then a punt on the 2nd one. We talked about Alabama's success early in the ball games. Look at that. One of the last 36 games in which they have led, and they have a 28-game winning streak coming into this one this afternoon. Phillips and Garner out of the eye. Quick 3-step drop by Shuler, complete to the near sideline. That was Corey Fleming.
Well, I tell you, that first quarter thing's big. Now you can change that 6-9, 79-10. Alabama's outscored the Volunteers in the first quarter. That plants some seeds of doubt if you're wearing white and orange.
Tim, if you're a coach, there's really nothing you can do about that. Is it game preparation? Is there anything?
What do you mean there's nothing you can do?
Well, I wish, I bet you Phil Fulmer wishes he knew what he could do about it.
Just give the halftime speech before the game starts.
There you go. To the near side again, complete to Fleming for the 2nd time in a row. Fleming, a 6'3", 270-pound senior from Nashville. Pardon me, 207 pounds.
He's a great story, too. He was a high school quarterback, actually ran the wishbone. He's a 6'8 high jumper. He was the best high school player to come out of Tennessee. Sat out, actually backed up the quarterbacks the first 2 years. He said, Coach, I want to play. So they moved him out to wide receiver, and he's a good one.
3 wide receivers in for Tennessee. A nice runoff tackle that time out near midfield. A 10-yard pickup that time.
Well, I tell you what, Tennessee's offensive line is firing out now, and it's big, it's strong. Offensive line averages 290 pounds. Watch him fire out here and control the defense. Bang, get a great block up there by Miller, 71. Then they shield back once he's into the secondary. Move those chains again, first down.
Garner, a versatile back, a good runner as well as a good receiver out of the backfield. 7:02 to play in first quarter. Garner and Brunson out of the eye. Shuler over the middle, complete at the 39-yard line for Craig Faulkner. And another first down for the Vols, a pickup of 11 yards.
I'm going to tell you something. Shuler can run and he can throw, but I think the best thing he does is handle the ball. He's like a cowboy. He rides the fakes until the linebackers are tied up. Then he just threw back to Faulkner, who dragged himself all the way across the field from the wide flanker slot.
Shuler 6 of 7 so far, a total of 30-yard passing. Garner and Brunson again in the backfield, out of the eye. First down and 10. Coming to the wide side of the field, complete at the 35. Jones with the catch that time. You can almost sense Shuler finding his rhythm now, Tim, on this third series.
Tell you what, he's not backing away from Antonio Langham either. He's working both corners. I talked to him yesterday and I said, when you break that huddle, is one of the first things you do to locate Langham. He says, I know where Langham is in every situation.
He's watched a lot of tape this week in anticipation of this game.
He also dreams about him.
A carry to the fullback, Moles Phillips, down to the 26. That offensive line for the Vols really firing off the ball in that play. Tackled by the strong safety, Sam Shade. So Tennessee, the 10th ranked team in the country, moving the ball here on their third series.
Let's talk about Alabama's defense for a second, though. You know, they were a 3-4 when they played Tennessee last year. Now they're running a 4-3. Alabama moves it around to play to its strength, create depth, switch schemes for different looks, and also rest people at times.
Back to the weak side. It's complete to Fleming. Corey Fleming, and he could score. But there's a flag down. And Fleming is down at the 2. But there's a flag back at the 28-yard line. Let's see what it's about. Fleming bounced off a couple of defenders that time and picked up 25 yards.
I like this end. This is going to be against Tennessee. Move them back. That'll drive Phil Fulmer crazy. They're killing themselves with mistakes.
Fulmer telling us yesterday that since he got the head coaching job, he's put on about 20 pounds and lost a little hair.
Yeah, you know, he played for Tennessee in the late 60s, early 70s. Played at 215.
Offense lined up in a neutral zone. 5-yard penalty. Previous squad. Still first down.
Now the 20th coach is at his alma mater. Players love him. He's like a player's coach. They know he's been down on the field. He's played with them. He's not much older than they are.
Talked about losing hair. A few more plays like that for Tennessee, and he'll be a candidate for Hair Club for Men. 5:45 to play in the first half. Five wideouts, five receivers for Tennessee.
And Alabama goes back to a 3-4.
And Shuler takes off. Down at the 25-yard line. He needs about 8 to go for the first down. Tackled by Michael Rogers.
Shuler is now a junior. Played some as a freshman. Started as a sophomore and continues to improve every game. Speculation now that he may come out this year and go to the National Football League.
A lot of scouts rate him extremely high.
He's got a great arm.
Built more like a receiver or a tailback. Second down and 8. Shuler gets rid of it down the middle. Touchdown to Faulkner. A 25-yard strike.
The defense, they were locked in man coverage. He just laid it out there.
The extra point is good by Vexburg. 94 consecutive extra points.
Aaron, you be in the secondary. Take a look of it. There's Nunley, 73, applying the pressure. But they had Donley beat. Faulkner saw the man lock on. Touchdown. Shuler says, yes, sir.
Keith Shuler, Tennessee, phoning the SID department saying, guys, that's a record. I hope you got it. That touchdown pass was the 19th this season for Tennessee, for him.
I'll tell you something, too. It's the first time that Alabama has trailed this year. As a matter of fact, you have to go back to the first quarter of the championship game in the SEC last year.
Let's see how they respond. The kickoff down to the 7-yard line to Kevin Lee. And Lee is brought down at the 25. Actually, since the opening game of the 1992 season, they've only trailed 4 times.
Yeah, but look at this. You think that's not amazing? Look at the minutes played, and the total time that they've trailed is 29 minutes. It's unheard of.
So they're in an unfamiliar position right now. Tennessee with a 4-point lead with 4:48 to play in the first quarter.
Key for both sides is patience.
Jay Parker has proven that he has it. They fake the reverse, and it is a reverse to David Palmer. And he's got room. The deuce is loose and out to the 42. A 17-yard pickup for Palmer, the first time he touches the ball this afternoon. Tackled by Austin.
We talked about Palmer having to touch the football today. They're going to try to kick away from him, but Alabama's got to get him involved, so they do here. Williams on the reverse, gets it to Palmer. Fastest guy on the team, certainly the most talented, most dangerous when he has the ball in the open field. Got some great blocks. I mean, Barker even got one. The quarterback. Say, if Palmer has mastered the three R's, receiving, running, and returning.
I don't think Gene Stallings wants to see Barker throw too many blocks this afternoon, though.
Play clock was down, ready to expire. Barker had to take a timeout or face a delay game.
4:09 remaining in the first quarter. Tennessee answering that Alabama field goal with a strike of their own. They lead 7-3. If you see the sign that says Legion Field, Birmingham, follow that one. That's the most important one this afternoon. The score 7-3 for Tennessee over Alabama. First and 10. Williams looking to pass, and he's sacked. Back at the 37 and fumbles. Now, is it ruled a fumble?
No, he's down. If they even think about ruling out a fumble, they're wrong.
Shane Bonham lowered the boom on him. He hesitated before trying to pass.
All right, now defensively, you've got to be thinking about Palmer, okay? And they gained 19 yards on the last reverse, so here they fake it. But Williams is going to pick up and throw. Pretty good pressure from the outside. Jenkins was coming off the corner with pretty good support. Also got some help up front from Bonham. That's dedication right there.
They're 20 years old! 20 years old!
They look it.
Get some polish on those things. 3:18 to play. Second down, 14. Barker complete to Chad Key. And a first down at the 42-yard line. Great touch that time by Barker on that pass. A pickup of 20.
Mark, you made a pretty good point here a few minutes ago. You said it looks as if Keith Shuler's starting to find his rhythm, and he is. They're not getting to him. He's got time. Or Barker, rather. He's getting in his rhythm. He's got time. We talked about having to protect him. They're doing that. They're giving him time to throw. Once he finds that rhythm, he can throw. He has improved so much from last year. It's unbelievable.
Making the secondary reads a lot better. They go to fake it or try to reverse it, but only one problem. James Wilson had other ideas. A loss of 8 on the play.
Coming on a safety blitz. He's following Palmer right now. Well, I tell you what, they're spying these guys. They're coming with great pressure right up the pipe. James Wilson, he had 4 sacks coming into this game.
He got to Anderson before he could actually hand it off.
6'3", 251 pounds. He runs like a linebacker.
Auburn now mounting a bit of a comeback against Florida. Barker, play action, knocked away and fumbles. And he dives on it safely at the 37. Horace Morris knocked it away and stripped the ball from Barker.
You know, when we talked to the coaches, they said Horace Morris is a great athlete. Bench presses 400 pounds, he runs a 4.6. He's got great body control, just slaps the ball out of Barker's hands. They said the thing is, he's got to become a dominant pass rusher. Has not done that yet. Looked pretty good there. They're looking for consistency out of them.
Third down and Tuscaloosa to go.
Hello, Tennessee. Got Alabama going backwards.
Tennessee with a nickel package in. Barker to pass. And he hits Lynch, the fullback. Lynch, a huge load brought down on Tennessee side of midfield, and it's a fourth down. They're going to have to punt it away. So the Tennessee defense makes its first statement of the afternoon. Brian Deal standing on his own 38. A 48-yard punt. Next Saturday, ABC Sports presents exciting regional action. A huge win this afternoon against Penn State.
This is the first real big test for Alabama this year. Played Tulane and Vanderbilt and Arkansas and Louisiana Tech. But this is the real deal here.
A step up for both squads. Shuler fires complete. Fleming with a gain of about 8 on first down.
Well, see, now I think Tennessee has played a tougher schedule. As a matter of, fact, they played Florida already, lost that game. It was a wild one, 41-34. But I think it helps a team like this. Not the loss, but, I mean, having played that tougher schedule when you come in to play Alabama.
Tim, what are your thoughts on the extra week for Alabama to prepare? Does it make that much of a difference?
If you're banged up, an off week helps. But I don't like it because it takes your momentum away. 5-0 and have to sit out.
Shuler now has hit 7 straight passes since that interception. They won it on this play out to the 33-yard line. That's the backup fullback, Mario Brunson. He had only 2 carries coming into this afternoon. Tackled by Kelvin Moore. 20 seconds to play here in the opening period. It's Tennessee against Alabama.
They love the way Brunson blocks, too. Jams it right up there. Vicious blocker. Hurt his knee last year. Had to sit out.
Well, that run by Brunson was the last play of the first quarter. And a bit of a surprise in the fact that Tennessee leads. One of the few times Bama has trailed this year. 7-3 after one. John Mark Stallings, one of the many people on hand here this afternoon. Coach's son for Alabama.
That's the Stallings clan and their friends.
First down and 10 for Tennessee. Shuler checking off at the line of scrimmage.
Still has plenty clock left. 5 seconds on the play clock.
He hands it off up the middle to the fullback, Mose Phillips. Back to New York and John Saunders. John?
Mark, in the Big 8, Oklahoma unbeaten facing Colorado today. Cordell Stewart underneath the coverage to Charles Johnson. And he will not be caught. 64 yards when he reaches the end zone. And the Buffs have opened up a lead of 13-0 over the Sooners. Mark, back to you.
All right, John, you have to wonder if that Texas game took something out of Oklahoma last week emotionally, if nothing else. Right here at 2nd down and 7. Just underway in the second quarter. Shuler to pass. He completes it at the 50-yard line to Billy Williams. The speedy wideout, a pickup of 14 and a first down.
Boy, Tennessee's playing well right now. Alabama came with a corner blitz, and Tennessee picked it up, gave Shuler the time. Shuler now has hit 10 of 11. 1 touchdown and 1 interception. Watch the right hand of your screen. They come with the corner blitz. They pick it up very nicely. You see Garner pick up the blitz, give Shuler that extra second, drills it out there. He's got one-on-one coverage. First down.
Langham, after that play, was shaking his head as if he should have had an interception. But Williams had good position. Play action by Shuler. Fires another strike and another first down, this time to Corey Fleming.
Hey, I'm going to tell you something. Heath Shuler right now is in a zone. He has hit 9 straight passes since he threw that one interception.
He gives you so many different dimensions. A strong arm, good leadership, and a very dangerous runner when he decides to run. Look at his numbers this afternoon. Just one incompletion.
And you know what that shows me? That shows me a quality quarterback who wasn't shaken by the interception but comes back and maintains his composure.
First and 10 for the Vols. Hand off, off tackle that time, down to the 33-yard line. Garner. Garner coming into the game averaging 6.4 yards a rush.
Got to give the Tennessee offensive line a lot of credit here. Now, these guys are meat grinders, but they've been relatively inexperienced. I mean, Lehman was a center. They moved him to tackle. Mays was a defensive lineman. He's now playing left guard. Ratliff really hadn't had much experience, but right now they're playing well and dominating the Alabama front.
Alabama in a 3-man front on this play.
They do that when they expect a pass. And they're right.
Quick drop by Shuler. Fires another bullet. Complete to Joey Kent. His first catch of the afternoon. The tackle made by Willie Gaston.
Shuler with... This game is special for Joey Kent. You know, he's from Huntsville, Alabama. Coming back here to Legion Field to play. Wearing that orange. Kind of makes the chest stick out a little bit. Yeah, look at him. See, he says, all right, guys, I got it. I got my catch.
And little TV time with that reception. Kent, just a freshman, 6'1", 175 pounds, but like so many Tennessee receivers, present and past, he can fly.
He's close to the first down. They bring the chains all the way across the field.
You see the indication by the official. They are just short of the first down.
All right, so most of the first quarter and here in the second, Tennessee has gone without a tight end. They've been using three wide receivers, but now they bring in David Horn, the tight end, because it looks like they're going to jam this thing right up there and try to get the first.
Third down and short. Two tight ends in, Scott Pfeiffer and David Horn. Brunson and Stewart in the backfield, but Heath Shuler says, I'll do it myself, fellas.
Yeah, Heath's also a very smart quarterback. See what he did? He got right on the butt of big old Bubba Miller, the all-SEC freshman.
Back to New York and John Saunders.
Mark, Heath Shuler having a big game, and here's the guy he's chasing for the Heisman Trophy. Charlie Ward hooks up with Kamerick Vanover, and this one's 86 yards. Look at the speed of Vanover to the end zone, and Florida State number one with a 7-0 lead. Mark.
All right, John, two guys with an eye on the Heisman Trophy, Shuler and Ward. First down, and Shuler is down at the 32. The sack by Jeremy Nunley, his fifth of the season, that leads the Alabama defense.
This is a coverage sack. I mean, Nunley's coming hard, but if you see Shuler has to reload because there's coverage on the left side. See, he looks left, has to reload. Nunley just overpowers the blocker. Actually, Garner missed the blocker. Stewart, correction. But Nunley's been on a tear the last four games. 20 tackles, four sacks, five stops behind the line.
And he figured prominently in their last win against South Carolina a couple of weeks ago.
That's only the third time Shuler's been sacked this year. Nunley, 6'5", 279 pounds.
Second down and 15. Garner, the lone tailback. They try to run the flanker screen, and they set up a screen in the backfield for Garner, and he drops it. They faked the flanker screen and came back the other way.
Double screen. Kelvin Moore did a nice job, big old 95, to get out there and break that thing up.
That also breaks the string for Shuler. He had 10 straight. Now he throws that incompletion. Penalty against Tennessee, but it's declined. And the nose of the ball is just past the 36-yard line. 11:45 to play in the first half. It's second down and 20.
Second down and forever. They'll go down to the three-down linemen again, put the nickel package in. Alabama defensively.
Bexbert anticipating a field goal, warming up on the sidelines. Shuler all day and down and fumbles. Alabama ball. Jeffries on the recovery.
Blitz, 36, strips him from behind. Boy, they get a great push with the three up front. Then they bring the linebacker on the blitz. Turnover, number two.
Stallings loves it. Back after this.
Andre Royal, watch the left hand of your screen. Royal's just 215 pounds, working on 75. Ratliff, who's 300. But watch, he stays with it, gets rid of the block, now comes and makes the strip from behind.
Back to the action, it's Sherman Williams on first down. He runs off tackle over the left side and has a nice gain. He's tackled by Reggie Ingram, number 41. Now, there was a little bit of jump talking going on between some of the different factions between the two teams. Ingram, talking about Barker, said He's no Heath Shuler. He looks better this year, but Ingram said he's definitely no Shuler. That got back to the Alabama campus. Here's Tarrant Lynch. Tough running up the middle. He'll have about two on that play. And Auburn has scored again to take the lead. Less than 2 minutes remaining in that ball game. Pardon me, 13 minutes to go.
What a great game that is. What a job Bowden's done with Auburn this year. Surprised everybody.
Ten and a half to play here in the first half. Tennessee with a 7-3 lead.
I'm still trying to figure out what the trash talk is you're talking about with Ingram. I mean, he stated a fact. That's true. I think Barker will agree with that.
Yeah, I really think that it's a first down for Bama. What some of the Tennessee players may be trying to do by making those kind of statements is trying to get Heath Shuler a few more votes maybe in the Heisman race.
Well, they won't upset Barker because he'll be the first to tell you he's not a Heath Shuler. But he plays within himself and knows his skills probably better than anybody in the country, and he is underrated.
Williams in the backfield. And this time, he'll lose a couple of yards. Swarmed at the 45.
You know what's amazing to me, Mark? What's amazing to me is Alabama's run the ball now 9 times and has yet to throw on first down. This is first down, so if I'm playing defense for Tennessee, I say, well, here they come again. They're going to run. They do. They get them. Got to mix things up. Got to break your tendencies. Put the defense on their heels a little bit.
Key point so far, David Palmer's only touched the ball once, too, on that reverse. Pardon me, twice. He looks to Palmer's side this time, but throws underneath to Johnson, the tight end, and he's down at midfield at the 50. Tony Johnson, a big target at 6'5", 248 pounds.
It's a well-designed play. You had Palmer out there wide. You had him drive off the defensive back and just bring Tony Johnson underneath in the void, the area, the open area.
Johnson had 7 receptions coming into the game for a total of 70 yards. Sets up 3rd down and 8 for Stallings crew. Stallings told his team he just wanted them to have some fun, but the fun comes in winning. 3rd and 8 for Palmer. What a grab! The deuce! And a first down.
Hey, don't anybody in this country tell me Barker can't throw. Barker can throw with the best of them. He's not Heath Shuler, but I'll tell you, this kid is a quarterback. Watch him step up and throw this on a rope. This is pretty good coverage on Palmer, but he puts the ball right where he has to, right over Austin. Palmer goes up and makes a catch. Well thrown by Barker.
David Palmer took the elevator to the top floor that time, extending all 5'9" of them.
Well, I tell you, Barker's much more confident, making better decisions than ever before.
Lynch and Williams out of the eye. This is Williams. Getting to the corner. Sherman sliding at the 20. Upended by Deron Jenkins, but a pickup of 11 yards, and the tide is rolling.
Watch the blocking up front. Hammond, Clay, Shields, Stevenson, Patterson, they all lock on right now and close the gate. Now, he just beats containment to the outside. Victor Brown, the strong safety, was late coming over on run support. C-16, he should have been out there earlier. Got to play inside out, but you've got flood containment. You've got to force him back in to where the help is, and they didn't do it.
Little slide on the backslide, huh?
He runs recklessly, doesn't he?
And here he is again, this time drilled at the 21 by Reggie Ingram, the hitman. Ingram, one of the real leaders of this Tennessee defense.
He had 14 tackles last week against Arkansas. Ingram did. This is a talented group of linebackers, probably the strength of the Tennessee defense.
They made a change this week, putting Galyon in for Kidd. Well, they have 3 starters back from last year.
This is almost sacrilegious, but coaches and players feel in recent years this Tennessee-Alabama game has become bigger than Alabama-Auburn.
Don't let Auburn fans get wind of that. Barker, play action. Tries to run and is sacked to the 25. Good coverage in the Tennessee secondary that time. The sack by Yatkowski.
That's one of those ones. Yatkowski will throw the fist in the air, but he was actually blocked pretty well. He didn't have any penetration, but when Barker stepped up to avoid the pressure from the outside, there was Yatkowski. He's a finesse guy. Gets off his blocks, makes pretty big plays. Watch number 99. See, they double up on him. He's not going anywhere. He's blocked out. But here comes Barker. Now Yatkowski says, hey, hold on here. I might get something. He does.
And Horace Morris, Tim, also in the backfield. 6:22 to play in the first half. Third and 15. Laid out. No interference. No flag. Palmer incomplete.
I'll tell you what. There should have been interference called there because they were bumping and grinding while that ball was in the air.
That's Ronald Davis with his arms up. Now there's a guy that said nobody can beat me one-on-one, including David Palmer.
There was definite contact with the ball in the air. That's pass interference. No call. The officials missed this one.
Michael Proctor in to attempt a field goal from 42 yards out. He's 6 of 10 on the year. This would be his long for the season. And it's no good. He missed it to the right. Alabama missing a golden opportunity. They still trail 7-3. Catch the story, 9 o'clock Eastern time on ABC, Monday night. First and 10 for Tennessee. Shuler finds a man wide open in the slot, and a fumble. Faulkner coughs it up, and Alabama gets it back. Whew. Will Brown strips it loose from Faulkner, and Romanski Hall fell on the ball.
Man coverage. Post pattern, he has it. Now watch 17 come out of the right hand of your screen and actually rake it out with his right hand. Bam, right there. Great play by Will Brown, the junior out of Syracuse. Romanski Hall, the Butkus Award candidates, right there to pick it up.
Is it me or does Alabama seem to make a lot of those plays? Remember George Teague against Miami last year?
Well, that's three in this game. Three turnovers by Tennessee.
Good field position for the Tide. Williams, nowhere to go. Sacked by Raymond Austin.
Remember how Sherman Williams was delivering the blow early in the ball game? Looks now like he's running tentatively.
Is that because the defensive front for Tennessee is getting more penetration?
Well, it's a couple of things. Number one, he's searching for the hole, which is being closed down. So he's being patient, but at the same time, when it's time to explode, he's not really doing it. He's not making the decisions quick enough.
They lose five on first down, second and 15. Lynch and Anderson in the offset eye. Play action by Barker. Wide open, but he misses David Palmer at midfield. That's the first time that Barker hasn't looked solid on a throw today. That'll set up third down and 15.
Right now, Tennessee's defense is controlling this football game. Alabama with the longest winning streak in the country, 28 games. They've got to feel that pressure a little bit, too.
Palmer this time lines up in the slot. Five DBs in for Tennessee defensively. And they go up top to Kevin Lee. And it's completed the 25. Barker on the money that time. Lee beat Deron Jenkins for 40 yards and a first down.
Boy, if I'm Deron Jenkins, I'm thinking, what the heck do I have to do? I'm in his hip pocket. This is good coverage, but watch the catch by Lee. We told you he was a high jumper. Also has great concentration. Now, Jenkins popped up and said, wait a minute. He was bobbling the ball when he went out of bounds. They rule it a catch. That's great concentration by Lee. Pretty good coverage by Jenkins.
I thought he had it. Obviously, the official did, too. The ball in the 25, first and 10. Williams running authoritatively that time down to the 17-yard line. Sherman Williams, as we mentioned, came into this game with a string of five consecutive 100-yard outings.
Yeah, he needed that run, too. The entire offense did. The last seven carries, they got only 9 yards, so they need to bust a few, get that confidence back.
Averaging only 3 yards a rush this afternoon.
keep in mind, this Alabama offensive line lost only one starter from last year's club, but that was George Wilson.
Lynch and Williams in the offset eye. Palmer in motion. It goes to Williams, and he's down at the 21-yard line.
I think Sherman's getting a little frustrated right now.
Maybe a little winded, too.
As soon as he touches the ball, they're all over him.
Shane Bonham making the tackle that time. Williams is going to come out of the ball game. The last time Alabama was in the red zone, they missed a field goal. Third and five. Parker sacked back at the 30. The Tennessee defense, led by James Wilson, sacking Parker.
Wilson's fifth sack of the year. We told you, 6'3", 250, reminds me of Monty Coleman of the Redskins. He's got great speed, most consistent defensive lineman, and he's very physical. Look at him here. He's being held. He breaks loose from Stevenson, forces Parker, and makes the play.
Michael Proctor into attempt a field goal from 47 yards out. He's 0-for-1 on the afternoon. His long this year is only 31 yards. This one is dead center. Michael Proctor says, take that. I'm back. And so is the tide. They trail 7-6. So Michael Proctor caps a 7-play, 32-yard drive, using up 2:55 on the clock with a field goal. And that ties his career record for distance.
Tell you what, those two field goals were hard-earned, too. Tennessee defensively has not given up anything.
That defensive front, which is a little on the small side, doing a great job this afternoon. Kick down to the one to Garner. And Garner is jacked at the 18-yard line.
You know, that penalty negated the one incompletion he's had here in this quarter. So Shuler's 13 of 14.
Moses Phillips on the first down carry. He has about 8 yards. 7 minutes remaining in that game at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Auburn leading by 8.
That carries a lot of impact for this game. Tennessee hoping Florida loses, but needs a win here.
Yeah, too early for them to even think about scoreboard watching.
All right, let's get back to Shuler watching. He's hit 11 passes in a row.
This guy is cut right out of the quarterback mold. Incomplete, it picked off. Alabama's Antonio Langham. You play with fire, you're going to get burnt.
There is a flag down. It's against Tennessee.
So the record stands for Antonio Langham.
Tennessee now with 4 turnovers and 2 key penalties that have helped the Tide.
And that's Langham's 5th interception this year. One of the best in the country, if not the best.
He also has 17 career interceptions. That breaks the all-time record at Alabama. He is now the record holder. Unselfish, consistent, a leader. Watch this. You can't play defense any better than this. Skates along with him, reads it, comes up and steps in front and makes the pick.
He thought he should have had one earlier in the first quarter, was shaking his head. This time, he came back and snagged it.
He should win the Thorpe Award. Probably will.
Williams, Tim, again, stopped up. Now, you made a good observation. Williams isn't coming forward to the line of scrimmage, attacking it the way he was earlier in the game.
Alabama with 21 runs now, and 10 of those 21 runs were for losses.
Tennessee defense.
I'll tell you what,
well,
if I'm Barker, I get those guys in the huddle and I start talking to my big guys up front.
Second down and 11. Barker wide open. Chad Key at the 12 and knocked out of bounds at the 10. It stops the clock with 1:36 to play in the first half. Knocked out of bounds by Jenkins.
Well, I don't know. Jenkins, the defender working on Key that time, was playing so soft on the corner, I couldn't tell if he was in man or zone coverage.
He was in another county is where he was. The nose of the ball just past the 10-yard line. Williams and Lynch lining up out of the eye on third and two. Williams trying to get outside and dragged down nicely that time by Ben Talley. A 6'3", 235-pound junior, the team's leading tackler. And the clock running with 1:20 to play in the first half.
He's having another great year. Last season, he had three fumble recoveries, several sacks, two interceptions, a blocked field goal. He's the big play guy.
Tim, again, if you're Gene Stallings, you have to be concerned that, pardon the pun, the offense is stalling in this part of the field. Proctor in to attempt a field goal from 30 yards out. He's one of one in the afternoon. We see you, Antonio. Make that 2 for 3.
Concern, yes. Panic, no. They keep banging away. They now have the lead back.
A good field goal gives Alabama a 9-7 lead.
These guys are the defending national champions. 28 wins in a row. They aren't going to panic.
Coming up on the Prudential Halftime, Antonio Langham may be the best defender in the country in the defensive secondary. 17 career picks.
I just gave him the Thornton Award.
When does he collect?
I got to run out to the Havoc Hole for you, but I ain't running.
You know, they have a lot of speed in that secondary. Not quite as much as last year. Last year, they had blinding speed. This year, their speed is just amazing. George Teague, of course, a first-round pick of the Green Bay Packers. He was on the other corner last year.
Yeah, we talked about Alabama losing John Copeland and Eric Curry to the NFL. George Teague, you mentioned. A lot of people really thought that the defense would be average at best, but they do have great speed. It's a great scheme, and the coaches do a good job of these guys. But I'll tell you, the defense is playing right now. It's Tennessee's.
The ball's trailed by 2, 9-7. Proctor with the kick. Back deep, Billy Williams and Charlie Garner. That's Garner. Makes a couple of nice moves. And Garner is down to the 26.
Flag down on the play. Remember that graphic we showed early in the ball game, and we said that Alabama trailed for only 29 minutes last year? Well, in this game, they've already trailed for 19 before they just got that last field goal.
How's this for a golfer's dream? 18 legendary holes from 18 of the greatest courses in America. John Daly, Tom Kite, Fuzzy Zeller, and Davis Love III for an unprecedented round of golf. The Chrysler American Great 18. Tomorrow at 4 Eastern, 3 Central on ABC. 42 seconds remaining in the first half. Tennessee trails with the ball by 2 points. The story of the first half has been the Tennessee defense, although they trail.
And turnovers. That's been a big score. 3 of them.
4 of them. That's Garner running well out to the 30-yard line and tackled by Michael Rogers. And the clock stops with 34 seconds to play in the first half.
Trying to hurry things up here. Schuler gets him in and out. Now he's going to call him back in. 4 turnovers has been the difference. 2 interceptions, 2 fumbles. Alabama's capitalized with 9 points.
They hand it off. A flag down. It may have been a face mask. Garner on the carry. He was tackled by Lemanski Hall and Kelvin Moore. One of those two got a hold of it.
Well, the face mask here. Cuts it inside. Now here comes Garner. There's the reach in. That's incidental at best.
There's Kelvin Moore. With 16 seconds to go,
I thought it was John Walters. Maybe they both had it.
Timeout Tennessee. Now with 16 seconds to play in the first half, getting into field goal range really isn't an impossibility. Bexbert has already kicked one this year from 51 yards out.
Tennessee has the two timeouts remaining, but only 16 on the clock. His career best is 53 yards, so they need to get to the 36 to put him within his range. So they've got to come up with a big play here.
And his only attempt from over 50 yards this year, he's made. That one, as I said, coming from 51 yards out. He's a nominee for the Lou Groza Award as college football's best kicker.
Lou the Toe.
The ball is on Tennessee's 41-yard line. What a ball game between Auburn and Florida. 5 minutes to play there at Jordan-Hare Stadium.
Shuler really has to be the curator of the clock here. He's got 16 left. He's got his two tees left, two timeouts. He probably called two plays in the huddle. As soon as that whistle blows, here he goes.
Four wideouts for Tennessee. Shuler comes to the near side. It's complete, and the clock stops. The ball is at the 47-yard line.
Play took 6 seconds. They move it down to the 46. He's got 10 left on the clock. Still has his two timeouts in his pocket.
Mose Phillips with a pickup of 13 yards. Shuler has so much more poise this year. He has grown a lot in one season.
What a great decision that was, too, because Fleming was wide open, but he was down at the 40, but he was by the hash mark. So had he caught it, they would have used one of their timeouts. The clock wouldn't have been able to stop like it did by stepping out of bounds.
10 seconds to play in the first half. To the wide side of the field, and it's incomplete. He throws a bounce pass intended for Craig Faulkner, and there's just 5 seconds to play.
That won't hurt him. He's telling Faulkner, though, got to come back, look over your right shoulder. That ball was underthrown. How about Faulkner? He's recovered from that wrist injury, almost ended his football career. Didn't play in the spring. As a matter of fact, said, that's it. I'll never play football again. This wrist is too bad. Decided he missed it so much, came back, plays with pain now. He's got a bad wrist.
The tendency has been to call him a possession receiver, but forget it. He has very deceiving speed. He's fast. Shuler open down the middle.
No time left.
That's it. Craig, you can't call timeout when there's no time left on the clock.
No time. It went off the clock as soon as he made the catch. He did go to a knee and tried to get the timeout, but too late.
Heath Shuler and the Tennessee Volunteers, after 30 minutes of play, trail Alabama. They've lost seven in a row to them, but the score is 9-7. We are about to get set here in the third quarter for the opening kickoff. Tennessee kicking off and Alabama receiving. John Bexbert kicking off from his 35, and Kevin Lee and David Palmer back deep. This is Palmer at the goal line. From Jordan-Hare Stadium, 38-35. So that drastically changes the complexion of this game.
Significant in the fact that Florida now has a loss, as does Tennessee. But head-to-head, which would be the tiebreaker, would be Florida having beaten Tennessee. But this is the way it stands right now in the East. What a job Bowden's done at Auburn.
They play the role of the ultimate spoilers this afternoon because, of course, they cannot go to a bowl game. They decided to take their penalty this year.
Almost using that penalty as a motivator to show everyone, hey, here we are and we can play.
Jay Barker passing on first down. Tarrant Lynch, the fullback, out of the backfield. And Lynch is out to the 33-yard line. Now look at the first half stats, Tim.
All right, that's one of the adjustments they made at halftime right there. They threw on first down for the first time today. If you look at these, take a look right here. 17 yards rushing. They average over 200 a game. And then here are the four turnovers for Tennessee. That's very unusual as well. Those two interceptions, two fumbles.
Those 17 rushing yards really underscores the great job that the Tennessee front four has done this year, this afternoon.
Well, Alabama was fairly predictable, too, let's be honest. But they throw on first down here to start the second half.
Here's Williams, who had a strong first quarter, slowed down in the second quarter. And Kerr is here for the first time in the third quarter and is tackled by Reggie Ingram.
See, Alabama with that schedule, Tulane and Vanderbilt, Arkansas, Louisiana Tech, South Carolina. Alabama was able to line up and just bully those people. They could say, hey, we're running right through the two hole. Here we come, try to stop it.
Do you believe Nunley there?
I'm not going to his barber, I'll tell you that.
He was yawning there on the sidelines.
That's what we were just talking about.
It tells the story. Williams, close to the first down marker. Not sure that he made it. He was stopped by Reggie Ingram.
Well, he had to get out almost to the 37. See where they mark it.
George Kidd also in on the tackle.
I don't think he's going to make it. Didn't make it. That's it. Bring up fourth down, punt it away. Tennessee has stopped him. But the point I was going to make is Alabama's been able to bully people and be fairly predictable and still win. They can't do that here against Tennessee.
A different type of beast they're dealing with this afternoon. Brian Deal punting to Sean Summers. Summers standing on his own 18. And Deal gets off. Nice punt, but it's returnable on the run at the 28. And good coverage as he's brought down at the 31. Here's a look at the game story so far, Tim. This is what we talked about, the important factors for each team. Tennessee throwing on first down and protecting Shuler. They've done at least the first throwing on first down.
They have done that. They've mixed their plays. Run-pass ratio has been fairly balanced. Protect Shuler, he's been sacked two times now. Of course, that's not what they want. He was sacked five times in the loss last year to Alabama, twice here today, so they've got to improve on that. But Alabama's been able to pressure Shuler and force turnovers, four of them.
Penalty decline, first down.
The ball is on the 31-yard line. This is Tennessee's opening sequence of the third quarter. We are just underway here.
Number one passer in the SEC against the number one pass defense in the nation.
Garner, the only back. The old counter tray. And Garner is tackled after a gain of about 2 yards by Shannon Brown, the nose guard, number 75.
Continue to make adjustments on the sidelines.
What are they doing? Where are they moving? How can we beat them and defeat them? This Alabama front seven, relatively inexperienced, but still the number two defense in the country. Second down and 8 for Tennessee.
Alabama with 3 down, expects Shuler to pass. They're right.
He's got trips left and badly overthrows a receiver, almost picked off by Tommy Johnson.
You know, Johnson reminds people of George Teague. They move him around. And I don't think Shuler really read that defense properly that time. It's just a roll to that side. They want to hit Horn in the flats. Here's 82, but the ball's overthrown, and you see Johnson 10 coming to take the corner. He'll get all-conference recognition this year, too, Tommy Johnson.
Had a couple of interceptions coming into this game. Third down and 8. 3 wide receivers out to the left, and Shuler will take off. He's got some tailback blood in him, and he's close to the first down. I think he got it.
He also is shaken up. Had the wind knocked out of him a little bit when he hit. Alabama loaded up. They only had 3 down, but everybody was within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage. Man coverage. He reads that. Everybody goes back to play pass defense. There, he takes a pretty good lick by Will Brown, the linebacker, knocked the wind out of him for just a second.
Yesterday when we were visiting with him, I asked him, Heath, how much do you really weigh? He says, with a smile, oh, about 225.
He's got a linebacker mentality. Reminds me of Jim Kelly.
The ball is incomplete at the 45, intended for Corey Fleming that time. They threw to the near side, and it was incomplete. And guess who's in town for the game?
Cornelius Bennett. You think he couldn't rush a passer? He came with bad intentions.
The man they affectionately called Biscuit up in Buffalo. 11:40 to play in the third quarter. Alabama leads 9-7. Shuler. And it's almost intercepted that time by Michael Rogers. It was intended for Craig Faulkner.
Tennessee went with its trips package. Three wide receivers. Now watch what they do. They'll run off. It's man coverage. Now here comes Rogers, 52, and he almost has the pick. It would have been the third. Oh, Shuler. Actually, that was a combination defense. Half zone, half man.
Three wide receivers to the bottom of your screen. A trips left for Tennessee. Five wideouts on the play. And he hits one right down the middle. And it's ruled incomplete now.
Watch the top of your screen. Number 12, Fleming. He runs a post. This is what they scored in earlier. The second receiver in is always the most dangerous because he has the most field to work with. But I'm telling you, he takes a pretty good lick right here by Willie Gaston, who's playing a heck of a game. There's the catch. There's the delivery. There's the ball shaking loose.
Gaston has already had an interception this afternoon, that time delivering the big hit. David Palmer calls for the fair catch at the 17-yard line.
Hunt and confront. Gotta love that defense.
Tied leading by a pair. Auburn unbeaten in SEC play. Parker on first down, incomplete. He tried to hit his back. Chris Anderson in the flat, but it was broken up by Shane Burton.
From the end zone, you'll see Burton, 84, get his big meat claws up there and almost held on to that thing. It was intended for Anderson, but again, they used some play action on first down, got away from the tendency of running. Didn't throw a pass on first until this half.
A player down on the field, that's John Stevenson, the starting right guard for Alabama. Now, he's back this week from a knee injury suffered a couple of weeks ago against South Carolina. You can see the brace that he's wearing on his left knee.
Watch the left-hand side of your screen, 69. Right there, all the way to the left.
It was Horace Morris that fell on his knee.
85, Horace Morris. You hate to see that. That is the knee's been having problems with.
That offensive line, what are the strengths of this Alabama team? They did have some concerns at the left guard spot coming into this game. 11:14 remaining in the third quarter.
Tennessee showing blitz.
On second down, Parker into the teeth of the zone. Picked off. Jenkins. Deron Jenkins. Tackled at the 28, and Tennessee gets a room service interception.
Bad decision. They tried to force it. They want to get the ball to Palmer. Tennessee showing blitz, then backed off and went into a zone. See Palmer get a pretty good push here. Now he goes back. Now watch Jenkins, the corner on the left side, read it all the way. Bad decision by Parker because he had the safety Brown coming over. Jenkins was playing underneath, in and out, and makes the pick.
Jenkins considered the best cover man in the secondary for Tennessee.
One of the biggest improvements in Parker this year has been his decision making on pass plays, but this is a very bad decision. He's locked on him all the way, never looks him off, and throws right into the zone coverage. That was room service, as you said, for Jenkins.
And a penalty against Alabama on the play.
For Jenkins, that's his third interception of the year.
So Tennessee now with the ball on the 28-yard line. And the officials still having a conference over this one. It didn't. They forgot to mark off the yardage after assessing the penalty. And Gene Stallings singing that popular refrain from Marvin Gaye's song, "What's Going On?" The ball at the 19, first and 10 for Heath Shuler and the Volunteers. They trail by two. The Tide defense swarming, tackling Charlie Garner on the play. The charge led by Will Brown. That penalty was for holding at the end of that interception return.
That's exactly right. That's the key. It was at the end of the play.
10.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Second down and 8. They hand it off to the fullback, and the Alabama defense has cranked it up just a notch here. Garner again on the carry. Will Brown again on the tackle.
That play was doomed from the start. They went to three wide receivers, no tight end. Made it look like pass, gave it to Garner, but Garner was stumbling right out of his three-point stance.
Bose Phillips, Tim, checks into the game, the fullback, and the tight end comes out. Tennessee with four receivers in. Garner the lone back. Third and 8. Shuler, and it's incomplete. Sam Shade, the strong safety, got a piece of the ball and tipped it incomplete. The pass was intended for number 80, Billy Williams.
Boy, this is a big-time play by Sam Shade. They were in zone coverage, read it all the way, and got his hand on the football.
So in now comes John Beckwith to attempt a field goal for Tennessee from 34 yards out. He's 4-5 on the season. And it's out of the hold of Lance Wheaton. And it's good. Beckford now 5 of 6 on the season and good enough to give Tennessee a 1-point lead. Back for the kickoff. That scoring drive by Tennessee. 4 plays, 12 yards, and the field goal by Vexburg after the interception.
But Tennessee can't be happy about that. That's a great defense by Alabama to keep them just to 3 points when they're down that far with Shuler at quarterback.
Tennessee has lost 7 straight, but they lead right now with 9:40 to play in the third quarter. David Palmer, 2 yards deep, and takes it out. David Palmer dancing and tiptoeing his way out to the 24. Give me 20, guys.
Talked about how big that defensive stand was, holding to a field goal in that last one. Here's the big third down play now. Alabama in zone. Go ahead and roll it, and I'm going to show you something. This is a big-time play by Shade. Stop it right there. Here's Shade. He's going to go over and get a hand on it. Garner's coming out of the backfield, was open. Here's the first down marker. Garner could have done it. Instead, Shade knocks it down. Great play by the safety.
Let's see how Barker responds to that interception on the last drive. Hands it off to Williams with a nice gain of about 6 yards. Coach Philip Fulmer, during that last timeout and breaking the action, really read his offense the riot act.
Yeah, see, he knows they should have gotten more than a field goal down there. He's upset about that. They had the penalty. They moved them down. They had they were down in the red zone, first down, and they come away with 3 instead of 7. That's huge.
Needless to say, he still gets involved in the coaching. Williams over the 30, met at the 32 and stripped, but no fumble. Scott Galleon led the charge that time.
Remember a couple years ago, I was sitting in Phil Fulmer's office. We were talking about some of his players. He says, "I've got an All-American named Tom Wojcicki. Wait till you see him." I said, "That's funny. I went to school at Maryland with a guy named Tom Wojcicki." He said, "That's his dad." He says, "You're getting old, too."
Older? Coach Fulmer says, "I got to get my tracksuit on and start losing a little weight. Games like this will make you put some pounds on." Third down and 2. in the flat. That's Lynch. He turns it up north-south, and he has the first down. A key conversion here in the third quarter for Alabama. Galyon again on the stop for Tennessee. Galyon's been improving week to week.
Yeah, Talley's shooting himself, too. Watch Talley, number 90 on defense right here. Stop it. Now, he's got inside-out leverage. That's perfect. But now roll it again and watch. He loses that leverage. Cut back by Lynch. Bad play by Talley.
No help to the AstroTurf either. Williams off tackle. And brought down by Talley after a gain of two.
Got to stay under control. Drop your butt. Break down. Inside out at all times on defense.
A capacity crowd on hand here in Birmingham, Alabama. The football capital of the South. Alabama with a 28-game winning streak. They've won seven in a row against Tennessee. Play action by Barker. Barker down at the 31. James Wilson with a sack, the fourth of the afternoon for Tennessee.
James Wilson, 6'3", 250. Watch number 72. Locked into the block, frees it right there. He's right here. He was being double teamed. Still fights his way off. 77 Patterson gets in and gets his third sack of the game. He now has seven for the year.
And sets up third and long, third and 15. They converted last time on third down. Let's see what they do here. Three receivers for Alabama. Barker downfield. Chad Key wide open, first down at the 47-yard line. Jay Barker, the picture of poise on that play, a pickup of 16 yards for Chad Key, who's been key a few times this season for them.
This is a mismatch. Key is using that 6'4 height. Working against Jenkins, who's just 5'10. Get it up high, let him pick it out. That is a mismatch size-wise. They ought to go back to that more often. He's a good-looking sophomore, isn't he, Key?
Yep. The last time Jay Barker lost a game was November 3rd, 89. Lynch on the carry. And he loses it. And Tennessee could take it to the house. A huge break.
What the heck happened to Lynch? That ball just comes right out of his hand. He's not even hit. Watch this. Here comes Lynch, 45. Gets a big push by the offensive line. Cuts back here in the hole. Now watch. He just loses it. He's not even hit. It comes out. Jenkins picks it up. And I think almost stunned. Alabama players just stopped. Look at this. They stop. Jenkins breaks loose.
I don't think Jenkins could believe it came right to him either. Stewart has about 3 yards. In the first half, the story of the game was Tennessee's turnovers. Two interceptions and two fumbles. Alabama now here in the second half is at two. We have 5:42 remaining in the third quarter. Jenkins with a key play. Lynch, a key turnover for Alabama. Jeremy Nunley says, no way, Heath. Let's go back to New York for an update on that Auburn game and how it ended.
Well, Mark, you can tell the folks at Tennessee that their game against Alabama just became even more important. Scott Etheridge with 1:21 left, 41 yards. Auburn knocks Florida from the ranks of the unbeaten. Florida with the win over Tennessee. If Tennessee can win, they'd be tied atop, Mark.
Here's Nunley right here. These guys pull. That leaves it wide open for Nunley, who never hesitates. Comes right off their hip, and he's in Shuler's face for the big loss.
Four wideouts for Tennessee on third down and six. Mose Phillips up the middle. Right up Main Street, and a first down. A big one, a pick of 16 yards before he's tackled by the safeties, Shade and Chris Donnelly.
Mose Phillips, 6 feet, 220 pounds. Watch out, quickly he reads this. Stop it, stagger step. He already sees the hole. The only one there is the umpire. Get him out of there. Use him as a blocker. Pick up the first down. Phillips out of Nashville, Tennessee.
Tennessee trying to snap that streak of 7 consecutive losses to Alabama. Phillips and Stewart in the backfield. Shuler changing the play and calls timeout.
Use that timeout to avoid the delay of game. Play clock was at 1.
And for Tennessee, the Vols lead 10-9. Shuler trying to change the play. Stewart cutting back. Cutting back. Stewart rolling all the way down to the 1 yard line. An amazing run by James Stewart. He broke about 3 tackles on the way down there.
Take a look at the blocking up front. Stewart follows it big. Cuts back, and then in. The linebackers have already run it over. Rodgers, 52, overran the play. The safeties have to come up and help out. Tommy Johnson, the cornerback, finally wrestles him down, but this is a big-time run by James Little Man Stewart.
First and goal. Over the top, nothing doing.
How about this? Only Arkansas has had a goal-to-goal situation against Alabama until this series right here. Look down the line of scrimmage. Here's what you want. You want these guys to penetrate, take everybody out, let the linebacker fill over top, and that's exactly what happened. Great goal line defense. Meet them in the air. Got to establish a new line of scrimmage by the defensive line. They do that. Everything's clogged. Linebackers and DBs come over the top. Excellent goal line short yardage.
Boy, you got equipment flying down there. I love it. The toss to Stewart. He fumbles. Alabama with the ball. Shannon Brown recovered the fumble.
Can you believe this? Turnover City. Here's Stewart again after the big play. Tries to cut back and just loses the handle.
Now
like
we know
Lynch before, not hit at all.
He knows exactly how Lynch feels now.
He's looking for the hole, and he's not looking for the ball. Consequently, he doesn't get the pitch and loses it.
Barker hands it off tackle on first down. That's Sherman Williams, and he's collared back to the floor, but his forward progress will give him a gain of about 5 or 6 on the play. Reggie Ingram in on the tackle. But can you believe the turn of events? First Lynch, then Stewart.
I'll tell you what, anytime there's a pitch, it's just like a pass. You can't take your eyes off of it for a second. Watch this again. After this play, we'll take another look, and you'll be able to see that he's not looking at the ball.
2:40 remaining in the third quarter. Sherman Williams looking for a hole and bores his way out to the 14, close to the first down. Let's take another look at that play, though, Tim.
All right, now watch Stewart. He's the tailback. Here comes the pitch. Watch his head. All right, now stop right there. He's already looking this way. Consequently, doesn't get the pitch. It's gone. Fumble, turnover number 5.
5 turnovers for the Vols, 2 for Alabama. Both of the Tigers' turnovers have been in the second half. Tarrant Lynch, who fumbled on his last carry, gets the first down that time. And he had both hands on the ball.
I was just going to say, Darren Lynch, wrap that thing up that time. Stadium is rocking.
This has got to be one of the greatest atmospheres for all of college football. Williams and Lynch in the backfield. This is Lynch again on first down. Gain of about one on the play. At the conclusion of today's game, we'll be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. And for the 23rd year, through this Chevrolet Scholarship Program, $1,000 will be donated to the General Scholarship Fund of each school.
Another big play by Ben Talley, the outside linebacker. Watch this. We used to call this the R stunt. He's coming right down here, and he's going right after the football, untouched. They move him to the weak side so he doesn't have to lock up with a tight end, and he comes down free.
55 seconds to play. Palmer on the end around. And he puts it on the ground.
Hey, we've got to check that football.
There's a flag down on the field, too. Back at the 20-yard line.
It's like they're playing with a bar of soap.
It's ruled an incomplete pass.
I don't know how that's an incomplete pass. That's a lateral. They're blowing the whistle right now. That's why he stops. Boy, get on the football right now. Get on it. Whether the whistle blows or not, but it's like they're playing with a bar of soap.
Sandlot football.
How can he call that an incomplete pass?
I think Gene Stallings wants to know the same thing. Here's the official.
The pass went forward. It was incomplete.
Oh, I know.
Turn it down. Holding. Offense.
I know what you're
doing. Penalty coin.
They call it on Palmer throwing the forward pass. Although I don't think he meant to. Did he? Here comes Palmer. Now watch this. Yeah, I guess he did.
That's not a pretty one.
That's weird.
I'm not sure. 49 seconds to go regardless in the third quarter. Barker threw behind his intended receiver, Chad Key. He never seemed to get set in the pocket, Tim.
No, give that incompletion to Ben Talley. Ben Talley was coming down. He had already gotten to Barker a couple times. Barker can feel him and then releases before he wanted to.
You can almost see the hesitation there in his pump face.
Boy, Wilson was right back with him, too. Wilson and Talley.
John Summers standing on his own 40. He's driven back by this punt. He'll get a chance to return it at his 30. And Summers is decked at the 32. A 54-yard punt, 3 on the return, but a flag down.
It's going to be a push in the back by Tennessee.
A tackle by Matthew Pine on the play. Tennessee.
Watch the left-hand side of your screen. Here comes the push in the back right here.
On the return. Illegal block in the back. Receiving team. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Well, tomorrow night on ABC, it's America's Funniest Hour, starting at 7, 6 Central Time. Then see if Superman has met his match on Lois and Clark, The New Adventures of Superman. And Fall in Love All Over Again. Julia Roberts and Richard Gere star in Pretty Woman. The Sunday night movie tomorrow on ABC. Nothing pretty about the last few minutes of play. A couple of fumbles by both teams. Garner up the middle. A gain of about 5 on the play as time winds down in the third quarter. 20 seconds to go. Alabama with a pair of turnovers in this quarter. Tennessee with a more crucial one. Down near the goal line.
Beginning of this game, we talked about how evenly matched these two clubs are. 10-9 indicates that's the case.
That's the end of the third quarter. Alabama players holding up four fingers, but hey, Tennessee has the lead. We'll return with more action after this message and a word from our ABC station. We're back at Legion Field in Birmingham, Alabama on the third Saturday in October. The score here, Tennessee leads Alabama 10-9. I'm Mark Jones, along with Tim Brandt in the house, and this has been Turnover Saturday on the third Saturday of October. 7 in all in the game.
5 by Tennessee.
Alabama with its 28-game winning streak on the line. Second down and 5 for Tennessee. Shuler hands it off. They've got the first down and more. Garner. He's got one guy to beat. Chuck Garner scores a touchdown.
There's not much up top. Hold it right here. Look at the hole through here. Everybody's strung out in pass coverage. He breaks it through. Now he explodes. And I don't know what Donnelly was doing. The safety, he was frozen in his tracks, 21. The only guy that really had a shot here was Langham. He catches him at the 1, wide 43, left hand of your screen, but he can't knock him out of bounds in time. The offensive line did a great job here. Miller, Big Bubba Miller, 71, got a key block. And Garner broke that tackle. Look at Donnelly, 21, the safety. Garner explodes for 73, and that's Tennessee's longest run of the year.
Garner got into the open field, turned on the jets and said, "See ya, and I wouldn't want to be ya." Two plays, 77 yards. You'd have to go back a long ways to remember the last time that Alabama not only trailed, but trailed this late in the ballgame.
For Garner now, 117 yards, third 100-yard game of the season and seventh in his career.
Bexbert with a kick, kicking it away from Palmer, but he gets it anyway. And Palmer is out to the 25-yard line. The last time Alabama lost was September 14th, 1991 against Florida, and they lost in a very big way. Eric Rett took the pitch, and that was the one of many touchdowns in a 35-0 shutout by Florida. That was September 14th, 1991.
All right, let's add another footnote to that. The Volunteers of Tennessee's last win over Alabama was 1985.
It's been 7 in a row. Lynch, the only tailback for Bama. Barker under pressure and sacked back at the 26 by Horace Morris. And the pendulum of momentum definitely swinging in Tennessee's favor now. See the time remaining in the fourth quarter. A loss of 8 on first down, second down and 18. Jay Barker, 22-0 as a starter. He hasn't lost since high school. Three receivers for Bama, but Barker has to scramble. Throws back across his body, incomplete. Intended for Todrick Malone. Take a look at the numbers, Tim, after three quarters.
Well, immediately you go down into the turnover category, 5 by Tennessee, 2 by Alabama. But I think the biggest stat thus far is right here. This is the rushing yards, just 46 for the Tide, and that's been huge. Have not been able to run all afternoon on Tennessee.
Tennessee with pretty good balance. 103 yards rushing, 180 passing, but the majority of that 103 coming on that touchdown run just a while ago. Third down and 18. More heat. Lynch, short of the first down, and the Tennessee defense is stepping up and taking this thing home, or trying to. Raymond Austin made the tackle.
You know, the last time Alabama trailed in the fourth quarter was 1992 against Mississippi State.
Deal number 12.
And look at the discrepancy in total yardage. Brian Deal into punt. He's standing on his 18. Sean Summers is on his own 27. A high but short punt. And he shanks one. It's going to be marked at the 42-yard line. Tennessee leads by 8. During that last timeout, everybody's coach of the year last year, Gene Stallings, burned that official's ears with a few comments. Tennessee with the ball, they lead by 8 points. 13-10 to go in the fourth quarter. Play action by Shuler, staying aggressive, tries to throw and run. Shuler with a pickup of about 7 yards. He wanted to pass that, but everyone was covered.
See, that's what makes him so dangerous. He can run, he can pass, he can do it all. Here, he reads in everybody's coverage. Shade stepped up and took the back out of the backfield. That's where he was trying to go. So he just tucked it away. And he's big and strong, 225 pounds.
Well, 35 to play in the fourth quarter. Tennessee leading by 8. They pounded up the middle on second down. That's Mario Brunson, who's tackled by Will Brown.
Tennessee wants to melt the clock, shorten the game as much as possible with 12:20 left. Heath Shuler's thrown only 5 passes in the third quarter. They were all incomplete.
Alabama has won 7 in a row over Tennessee, but one of the major differences that the Tennessee players say in this game is the fact that Philip Fulmer, the head coach, has instilled a different type of attitude in this team. They're a little bit more relaxed. Injured player on the field, that's Will Brown, number 17.
Yeah, I agree with you when you talk about Phil Fulmer. You know, he's now 9-1 as a head coach. But like Johnny Majors and all those who preceded him at Tennessee, he'll be measured by what he does against Alabama. And this is his first shot at the Tide. He's holding up pretty well right now with an 8-point lead.
As an offensive lineman, Fulmer was 2-1 against Alabama. He was an assistant coach at Tennessee for 13 years, so he's been involved in this game for a long time.
Will Brown up and walking off on his own. His dad's a minister.
He's got a little help there, you would think, on his side. That index finger quite yet. 12 minutes to play on 3rd and 1, and Garner gets the first down for Tennessee off tackle. Charlie Garner, who scored a touchdown on his last carry, gets the first down there.
Look at this, 119 yards, 12 carries. Slashing runner, the ability to cut back against the grain without breaking stride.
Three wideouts, they come to the short side, and it's almost intercepted. Jeremy Nunley put his big hands up there and almost ended up getting an interception.
Nunley uses that 6'5 height. He also has about a 7-foot wingspan. Uses it all here. Watch 73. Nunley comes unblocked, times this thing perfectly. Now he's looking for the interception. Can't relocate it quick enough. Actually had no shot at it. Great play, though, by Nunley.
It was Nunley that recovered the fumble earlier for Alabama.
You know, no team in this young decade has been more dominant defensively than Alabama. Although Arizona will argue that There's no question in my mind it's been Bama.
Time for them to show something here. Shuler passing, and he has another ball tipped and another ball incomplete. Sets up third down and 10. He tries to hit Mose Phillips as fullback.
On a radio show the other day back in Knoxville, they said, don't you think Heath Shuler should win the Heisman? I said, well, let me say this. Charlie Ward, I think with all the exposure he's gotten, the number one team in the nation, unless they lose, unless Charlie really screws up, he's in the driver's seat. It's his to lose. You see the numbers right here. Charlie even has the advantage in everything except touchdowns. And those touchdowns, by the way, are pass and run. Each have run for two touchdowns coming into today's games.
Shuler's just two for his last 11. Third down and 10. To the near side, it's incomplete. He's now two for his last 12. So Tennessee's going to have to punt. Alabama will get the ball back on offense. Shuler, unlike last season, though, where he would have become rattled, still fairly poised here.
Amazing. They want to melt the clock. I know they want to shorten the game, and yet they're throwing the ball, and the incompletions stop the clock. They didn't use much of it.
Tom Hunton putting from his 38. Picks it away from Palmer. Palmer calling for the fair catch. And this one doesn't even land inside the 20-yard line. It's at the 22. A 25-yard punt. Bama losing by 8. While we're in a commercial, Heath Shuler working the phones hard still. Good thing it's not long distance. 15 to 26, a pair of interceptions and one touchdown pass this afternoon. Jay Parker, meanwhile, his counterpart firing complete to the 39-yard line. Alabama has been on a roll since Gene Stallings stepped in 4 years
well,
ago.
I'm a steamroller,
you don't believe me? Look.
Baby. I'm on a roll all over you.
The longest winning streak in college football. 28 straight. Throwing a couple of SEC champs, titles, and a national championship. And here's the deuce. David Palmer. This is the time of the game that he loves. A 24-yard gain. His second catch of the day.
I'll tell you this. Alabama had him exactly where they wanted him. They got Palmer locked up on Ben Talley, the linebacker. Talley's awfully good, but I'll guarantee you he can't cover Palmer. Here's Ben Talley, the linebacker, 90. He's in a zone, but he doesn't get a good push off of Palmer. Palmer works into the open area. He can do that all day if they leave Talley out there in the hook zone.
Palmer this time lines up to the short side of the field.
That guy crosses your face like that. If you're a linebacker, you've got to put him on his back. If you're within 5 yards like he was.
Jay Parker going to talk it over with Gene Stallings. There's more than just one Shuler with Tennessee. That's Benji Shuler. He's younger brother, a receiver. A freshman. Parker to pass on first and 10. And it's ruled incomplete.
Boy, that's one that Barker wish he had to throw over again. Williams was wide open, and he knows it. Barker feels the pressure and gets outside. Look at this now. Hold it. There's nobody within 10 yards of Williams. And he picks it off the turf underthrown. It's awfully close, though. Oh. Call was made immediately.
To play in the fourth quarter.
Corner came up on a blitz that time. That's where Williams worked into the open area.
Lee in motion. Palmer split wide. A screen pass to Sherman Williams. Gets a nice kickoff block and he's down to the 30-yard line. He's about three shy of the first down, though.
Tennessee's got to get some flood control. There's nobody on the outside.
Third down and 3 for Alabama. Lee checks out of the game. And in comes Chris Anderson. split to the short side of the field. The back's in the pro set. Play action by Barker. And David Palmer makes the catch. And wrestles his way down to the 21. First down, Alabama. A 10-yard pickup by the Deuce.
That's a great-looking play. Anderson and Key both went to the left side, and that's where Barker looked. Then with the throwback to Palmer, had him isolated one-on-one.
You know, one thing we've seen Palmer do this afternoon, Tim, is break a couple of tackles. Gives you the feeling that he's deceptively strong, although he stands only 5'9". Palmer lining up in the slot to the left of Barker. The handoff to Lynch. Lynch stacked up at the 18. Tennessee leads Alabama 17-9 with 8:52 to play and counting.
Alabama, the longest winning streak in the country, 28 straight. On the line right here, and 8:45 remaining.
Tennessee came into this game saying, hey, we know that we've lost 7 in a row to Alabama, but that's really not the important factor here in the equation. The important thing is that this is an SEC conference game. That is first and foremost on our collective minds.
Tarrant Lynch is the player who's shaken up.
Philip Fulmer hoping to hang on. His team leads when we come back. Back at Legion Field, Tennessee leading Alabama. That's Tarrant Lynch, the first-ring fullback. Shaken up. They're looking at his leg. Hope to get a report from you soon. Barker. Into the end zone, wide open. Incomplete. Kevin Lee had a step on the defender. And it may have been just a touch overthrow. Underthrow, pardon me.
Ronald Davis raising his arms like it was great coverage, but he was beaten. Hold it right here. Here we have the lockup. Now let it roll. I'm even. I'm leaving. He's buying. Hit him right now. Davis is beaten, but Davis does recover enough to get his hands in the way. I don't know if he touched it or not. Lee probably still should have had that ball. That was well thrown.
Third down and 8. We'll see what Jay Barker comes back with. The 7th play of the drive.
Same play.
To Lee again. Incomplete.
Exact same play. Very same defense.
4th down now. And decision time for Gene Stallings.
This time it's Summers. Go ahead and roll it. Same formation, same play. Here goes Lee. Better coverage by Summers than Davis had on him. This ball's just overthrown.
Michael Proctor in to attempt a field goal for Alabama. It'll be his 4th one of the day if he makes it. This one coming from 36. He's 3 of 4 this afternoon. And he misses it badly to the right. That wasn't even close. So it remains 17-9. Boy, when Proctor has missed today, he's missed badly. Next Saturday, ABC Sports presents exciting regional coverage. Most of you will see number 2 Alabama roll into Mississippi. Illinois takes on Michigan. Fresno State takes on BYU, plus other regional coverage. 8:17 to play in the 4th quarter. Tennessee with an 8-point lead. Charlie Garner, straight ahead. He's the guy that made the decisive play in this game with that long touchdown run. He was tackled by James Gregory.
Defending national champions, Alabama. 28-game win streak. And it's not like they didn't have opportunities here today. The roll of the tide, the Crimson Tide, has been down there time again. They can only shake their heads. It's up to the defense now to stop Tennessee, to give Alabama another shot.
Backside of the eye. Handoff to the fullback that time. That's number 44, Mario Brunson. Known more for his blocking abilities, but that time he carries it. minutes to play.
Keeping guys focused after the national championship season is a job the coaches have done well, but this being the first major test of the year after a relatively easy schedule, right now Alabama's up against it.
A big third down attempt here for Tennessee. 7:10 to play. Third and two. Shuler on the option, and he has the first down. Tackled by Michael Rogers. There we see the great running ability of Shuler, but his arm seems to be a little sore after that play.
Lamansky Hall, the outside linebacker, got cut off. He had responsibility for Shuler. Watch number 11. He gets a block from the pull, gets tied up. That allows Shuler to get outside and get it up for the first before Rogers can at least slow him up.
Shuler was shaking his arm after that tackle, too.
Happened right here. Rogers got a lick on that arm and then got his leg tied up as well.
Regardless, they get the first down with 6:36 to play. Garner again. Back to New York, and John Sun. Is John, what's up?
Mark, Washington and UCLA. Wayne Cook once again. This one 6 yards to J.J. Stokes. Fourth touchdown pass of the day, tying Sean LaChapelle's record. 32-18. UCLA has the lead. Mark.
All right, John, I'm telling you, J.J. Stokes and Wayne Cook, maybe the number one pass and catch combination in the country.
You know, Shuler picking up that first down. That's only the third down conversion Alabama has allowed in the fourth quarter this year.
Time for the Tide defense to stand up. And they do in a big way, sacking Shuler. Brown, the nose guard, with a key play and a loss of 7 on the play.
Watch Shannon Brown. He does line up right smack in the middle of the formation. And when the guard pulls and Bubba Miller, the center, pulls, Brown had an open gate. Now, hold, stop it right there. Here's Bubba Miller, the center, has already moved out. All right, now roll it. He came clean. Nobody blocked him. Shannon Brown makes the play.
Another third down conversion that is paramount to the hopes of Tennessee. Third and 17 this time. They run it. Phillips. And Phillips is tackled at the 38-yard line by Chris Donnelly, a pickup of 15, shy of the first down.
Look at this. Look how, number one, Tennessee spreads the whole field. Here's a receiver here. Here's some receivers here. All right, that number one, that thins the defense. But then watch Will Brown comes up and misses the tackle. Stop it here. Here's Will Brown, overruns it. Then there's nobody left in the middle. Not enough for the first. It'll be fourth down and two.
David Palmer standing on his own 23. He has 4 career touchdowns off of punt returns. And a great punt. He calls for the fair catch at the 23. Tom Hutton with a big punt right there. 39 yards, but nothing on the return. Tonight on ABC, Billy Crystal, Meg Ryan ruined a wonderful friendship by falling in love. Well, that's subjective. When Harry met Sally. Then a drug dealer is selling to kids and the feds are protecting him. On an all-new commish tonight after the movie on ABC. Big story here, Tennessee trying to snap Alabama's nation-leading 28-game winning streak.
Obviously the biggest drive of the game for the year for Alabama.
Parker to pass on first down. Almost intercepted. He tried to hit Kevin Lee in the seam, but it was almost picked off by Ronald Davis. He's the guy that says not many guys can beat him one-on-one. They tested him there. It'll be second down and 10 for Bama. Jay Barker, 22-0 as a starter. To the wide side of the field, was looking Palmer's direction, but overthrew him by about 10 yards.
Great pressure by Tennessee that time, forced Parker to throw before he was ready. Everything starts Corey Stone, 98's coming. He gets doubled up. But then Barker can feel the pressure coming from the outside from Wilson. So he actually has to throw before Palmer even made his break.
Barker just two of his last seven, Tim. And a big third down conversion attempt coming up here for Alabama. 4:05 remaining on the clock. They trail by eight. Palmer split wide. Barker is going to take it himself. And he has the first down and then some. Jay Barker taking matters into his own hands, picks up 16 yards and stops the clock with 3:53 remaining and a first down for Alabama.
Here again, I can't figure out how he's getting outside. There's nobody out there to force him back in. Once he gets outside, he can go ahead and fake like he's going to throw. He knows where the chains are. He gets that and plenty more. There's no way he should get outside Tennessee's containment. Stop it right there. There's nobody here. Wilson got trapped inside, or as Morris was inside. And once again, Barker picks up the first.
We have a player shaken up. That's number 23, Sean Summers, a backup left cornerback for Tennessee. Back to New York, and John Saunders.
Mark, you saw Barker running there. Similar play in Colorado, Oklahoma. It's Cale Gundy, this one with a frightening result. Gundy out of the pocket, chased down by Sam Rogers, and his head hits the turf as he's tackled. Did not get the arm down. He's been airlifted to the hospital. He is conscious, but he does have a concussion. Colorado leads 20-10. Back to you.
Okay, back here on first and 10, Barker fired incomplete for Kevin Lee. He overthrew him just a touch high. 3:43 remaining, Tennessee leading by 8 points. Let's remind everybody that Auburn defeated Florida, so a win here for Tennessee, if they can hang on, would be a big lift for them. Second down and 10. Complete to Lee. Kevin Lee down to the 33-yard line. First down, Alabama, but a flag down at the 35.
Bring it back. I think it's going to be holding against Alabama. Doing everything they can, it is, to protect Barker.
He tried to find Lee, Tim.
Again, it's a zone defense. Lee just worked his way back into the open area, into the seam. Nice pass by Barker.
Offense, 10-yard penalty, spotting a ball.
That's huge. And remember, the holding is marked off from the spot of the foul. So it moves Alabama all the way back to the 25.
The injured player down in the field for Tennessee is the starting cornerback, Ronald Davis. He's taken off his right sneaker and is going to the sidelines.
This will be second down and 24 yards for the first.
You saw the look on Gene Stallings' face, shaking his head in disbelief.
John Stevenson, the right guard for Alabama, talking to the umpire. Tell him, wait a minute. Got locked up in there. I wasn't holding.
Stallings has taken Alabama to three consecutive bowl games. Done an outstanding job with that program. Second and 24. Chad Key complete and now knocked loose.
That'll be Alabama ball right there. Rolled out of bounds.
And ruled the completion, more importantly.
Not enough for the first, obviously, but it does get him back to the 41.
He picked up 17 yards. Raymond Austin made the hit on the play.
I mean, Austin tagged him, too. Look at it. Look at Key is still feeling that hit. Chad Key, the sophomore, goes up and makes it that nice catch on the ball. But then turn. Here comes Austin. Woo! I tell you, that'll put your eyes up in your forehead and rattle your fillings.
That was a rip shot.
Slobber knocker.
Barker, 16 of 30, one interception, 230 yards. Third and seven. And he overthrows Palmer. Decision time, Tim.
3:17 to go in the ball game. Third down and seven. I think I'd go for it. Gene Stallings making that decision right now.
And Chad Key, who had his bell rung on the last play, comes back into the ball game with the play.
Alabama is going to go for it on fourth down.
Their 28-game winning streak and their seven-game winning streak over Tennessee rides on this play. Fourth and seven. Barker wants to do it himself, but he won't make it.
Shuler's going to go in and make sure he tells everybody to hold on to the football. They want to melt the clock. If you're playing defense with a red jersey on your back right now, you're going to start raking at the football, trying to strip it, trying to knock it loose.
Alabama with two timeouts remaining still. Brunson and Garner in the game. This is Garner. Two hands on the ball, and Alabama signaling for one of its timeouts.
All right, that means Alabama has one left.
Why
clock is still running, and they bring the officials' attention to that, so they're going to have to put some time back on the clock.
Not many cards left in Gene Stallings' hand.
I'll tell you what, if I'm Gene Stallings, though, I'm starting to yell for more time put back on that clock.
There was at least four or five that seem to be ticking off while they were calling timeout.
No question in my mind, they called timeout way before 2:55 remaining.
That's not supposed to happen at home either.
I guarantee you, Rob Gilbert, the referee, is going to take care of that right now. That's the timekeeper.
The clock shows 2:55 remaining, but they'll probably wind it back to around 3 minutes.
I thought there were 3:04 left when he called timeout.
They're still discussing the matter. Jay Barker decided to run it on his own to try and make the first down, but he didn't make it.
Keep in mind now, what you see on the scoreboard is not the official time. The official timekeeper's on the field. This says 2:55.
Second down and 8 for Tennessee. Shuler hands it off again. And it's stacked up again. Garner the runner. A host of tacklers led by Nunley for Alabama.
That's the last timeout taken by Alabama, so they have absolutely none left now.
Coach Philip Fulmer on the verge of his first victory in his first meeting as a head coach against Alabama. Coming up after the game, the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report with all the scores of a very busy Saturday afternoon in college football. It's been an exciting one here at Legion Field in Birmingham, Alabama.
All right, the time on the scoreboard is now official. So it'll be a third down play, and there is now 2:50 left in the ballgame.
Third down and 9. Barker would love to get back on the field and have another opportunity. But that rests with the defense right now for Alabama. People wearing orange. Third down. Phillips and Garner in the backfield. Shuler takes it himself, and he's short of the first down. But the clock's still running with 2:40 to play. Alabama with no timeouts remaining.
No way to stop it. If you're on defense, you want to bounce up, get back off the field as fast as possible. You want to help the Tennessee players up, get them out of there. And the 2:20.
There's the feelings of the Tennessee faithful.
Eight in a row, nine.
Clock still running.
Stops at 2:12.
And there's more discussion down on the field. Tom Hutton is standing on his own 47, getting ready to punt.
Second. All right, they're going to reset the clock again to 2:17. Folks sitting down in Knoxville right now saying, what are you talking about? Put more time on the clock. We're trying to get it off.
We've had two discrepancies now this late in the game with the clock. Stallings hotter than July as a result.
He's upset because they won't come talk to him.
Would you?
Stallings is still out on the field. He better be careful. He's going to get a flag.
Hutton standing on his own 44. The clock running.
Look at this. He's on the field.
And the whistle blows. A delay of game penalty against Tennessee, and they'll back it up.
That takes a game clock. You know, I've got to be honest. I agree with Gene Stallings. I think this has really been sloppy clock management by the officials.
Questionable at best. We saw a discrepancy earlier with about 3 minutes to remain in the game, and they did not put that time back on the clock. Hutton, the lefty, high, and Palmer calling for the fair catch at the 18.
All right, folks, here we go. 1:44 to go. No timeouts remaining.
Jay Barker with the last gasp effort for Alabama.
Not only does Alabama have to score, but the Tide has to go for two, and that's something they haven't had to do all year. They have not attempted a two-point conversion this year.
Alabama in a very unfamiliar position, trailing this late and trailing period.
They practice this every single day. The hurry-up offense, two-minute drill.
Four wideouts for Alabama, 1:44 to go. He throws a short one to Turner.
Can't get out of bounds. Got to get him up to the line. And the clock will stop just to move the chains.
Talley making the tackle for Tennessee.
1:36. They move the chains to put it back in play. And already Barker has the offense at the line of scrimmage.
Palmer splits to the short side of the field. Four wide receivers again for Alabama. Barker to the short side of the field. To Palmer, who can't get out of bounds.
Clock continues to move. They'll stop it at 125, 126 to move the chains once again.
A 15-yard pickup and a first down for Alabama. The ball near the 45-yard line. Barker barking out the play.
Again, he's got him up to the line. As soon as they blow the whistle, he'll snap the ball.
126 and counting. Barker in the seam.
Oh,
and it's complete. What a catch. The Duke man, David Palmer.
Clock stops at 1:17 to move the chains. And again, Barker gets them up.
A 22-yard pickup and a big catch by Palmer.
The advantage the defense has here in a hurry up, Alabama goes from the same first count every time.
And Palmer keeps lining up in the same spot. Barker looking his way again. Palmer out of bounds with a gain of about 7. The clock stops with 1:11 to play. Deron Jenkins made the stop.
Now there's plenty of time. You're down in the red zone. You've got a minute left. But there's still no timeout, so you've got to work the sidelines. You don't want to change your rhythm, though. You want to keep the upbeat pace.
Alabama has moved the ball from its own 17-yard line down to Tennessee's 26 in less than a minute.
If I'm on defense, I got to locate Palmer right now. Here he is.
They trail by 8, 1:11 to go. Barker under pressure. He tries to get rid of it and is sacked. And the clock runs with 1:01 to go. George Kidd making the tackle that time for Tennessee. Less than a minute to go. Barker calling out the play. Palmer in the slot to the left of Barker. But he comes the other way to Lee. He steps out of bounds at the 18-yard line.
That'll stop the clock again. I'll tell you this. Tennessee should have been called for 12 men on the field, and they weren't. The side judge missed it.
46 seconds to go in the game. Alabama trails by 8. Kevin Lee picking up the first down. And Alabama in very good field position with 46 seconds to go.
Tennessee was trying to get a player off the field. He never got off in time.
Palmer lines up in the slot to the left of Barker. Barker looks right over the middle. No flag. There was some contact. Lee got bumped when the ball was in the air.
Look at Gene Stallings. He's down at the 20. Take another look at it. Top of the screen. Isolation. Here he is. See what kind of bump he gets from Jenkins, number 18. There's the shove. Incidental contact. That's a good no call. Good no call.
Stallings doesn't like the call. They move the ball 64 yards in just over a minute. 40 seconds to play. They trail by 8. Barker has the ball tipped, it looked like, near the line of scrimmage, and it's incomplete at the 12. The clock stopped with 35 seconds to go. Shane Burton may have gotten a hand on the ball at the line of scrimmage.
Shane Burton, 6'5". Look at him go up. Barker never looked off the receiver. Went to him immediately. Burton read that and went up when he released the ball.
They call the play in the huddle that time. And keep your eye on David Palmer. They go to the lead, and Lee can't get to it. And the clock stops with 30 seconds to go. It's going to be fourth down and 10. Davis providing the coverage on the corner again for Tennessee. Todrick Malone coming in now with the last gasp effort for Alabama. It's 28-game winning streak on the line.
More important than the touchdown right now is the first down. They have to get down to the 8.
He got it. He got it. Lee stopped at the 1-yard line.
23 seconds left. Clock stops again. They move the chain. Barker's got to get him up right now. He's got to go to the clock play and just down it.
They want to stop it. Stallings signaling to ground the ball.
That's the clock play signal. He's got to step up and just throw it down.
They're 6 inches from the end zone. And confusion down on the field. The whistles go before the ball is even snapped.
Well, I tell you, that was dangerous. Barker fumbled the snap.
Before the snap, timeout wipe.
Tennessee takes a timeout with 23 seconds to go in the game.
That surprises me. Alabama was still in a panic situation going to the clock play. This is a big, big play here. This was fourth down, remember.
Kevin Lee with the reception.
Worked his way open at a Mobile, Alabama.
Field in Birmingham, Alabama. I'm Mark Jones along with Tim Brandt, and it's the third Saturday in October. This one developing into another classic. Tennessee leads by 8 points with 23 seconds to go. I'm Mark Jones with Tim Brandt. It's first down and goal to goal Barker over the top. Touchdown. Terrific drive here, and then capped it off with this quarterback sneak. 11 plays, 82 yards, a minute and 23 seconds. The key, they kept getting first downs. The clock had to stop to move the chains. Now, Alabama has to go for two to tie this game, and Alabama is attempting it for the first time this year.
And this is it. Their 28-game winning streak on the line. Their 7-game winning streak against Tennessee on the line. David Palmer in at quarterback. He's a former high school quarterback. And a timeout down on the field charged against.
Timeout.
Not only was Palmer a high school quarterback, but they ran the wishbone. So if I'm playing defense, I'm looking possibly for the option.
Jay Barker, the number one quarterback. Oh, it's going to be tough for him to stay on the sidelines and watch this play.
But the most talented guy on that field, I think, is David Palmer. For Alabama,
no better way
to put the ball in his hands.
No better way to do it than to make him the quarterback. David Palmer was key in that last drive. He and Kevin Lee, they caught a lot of balls.
They
moved the ball down the field.
This is not something that Gene Stallings is just doing on a whim. They practiced this.
Palmer, throughout his career at Alabama, has thrown the halfback option many times.
What a drive by Jay Barker. Barker took him 82 yards without any timeouts and did it in 1:23.
For those of you that have just recently joined us, the story of the first half was four Tennessee turnovers. In the third quarter, Alabama turned the ball over twice. There's been a total of 7 turnovers in the game.
Alabama has not lost to Tennessee since 1985. They've got the longest win streak in the country. 28 wins in a row. Defending national champs. And here comes the two-point conversion.
Palmer's going to keep it. It's a tie game.
Yardage, none more important than these.
This is a terrible breakdown defensively by Tennessee. There's no way Palmer's coming up the middle. You've got to believe he's coming to the outside on an option or a sprint.
Now, Tim, 21 seconds to go. If you're Tennessee, what are you looking to do?
Number one, I'm not going to give him the opportunity to return the ball.
They don't have any timeouts remaining. So the clock is going to work against them.
Looks like Tennessee's expecting the onside kick. No way would I kick this deep. Look at this. Everybody's right here. If you've got a kicker that can pooch it, pop it up, that ball's live over here after it goes 10 yards.
Michael Proctor with the kick for Alabama. And he kicks it deep. We want to welcome those of you that are just joining us. Alabama and Tennessee are tied at 17 apiece. I'm Mark Jones along with Tim Brandt.
Alabama has just scored on a two-point conversion to tie the game at 17. And here's another look at it. David Palmer looked like magic.
Palmer, the wide receiver, came in to quarterback. They took Barker out. He hit the corner, got great seal off blocks, and Palmer with the two-point conversion here following a Barker quarterback sneak for the touchdown, and we're tied.
Jay Barker led them on a march downfield covering 82 yards.
Heath Shuler is 0 for 8 this half.
21 seconds to play. They hand it off. There's a flag down.
This ball's going to come back because of holding against Tennessee.
Mose Phillips with a pickup of 24 yards, but as you said, Tim, it is against the Volunteers.
No question about it. They tackled Shannon Brown.
14 seconds to play for the Vols.
Here's where they called it. They called it on Shannon Brown. He's tackled in the backfield. Watch this. Boom. Tackle right there. Takedown. Looked pretty good, though.
Let's take a look at the Jay Barker touchdown that put them to within two. Straight up over top.
It'll be first and 22, Mark, and again, Shuler has yet to complete a pass in this half.
And the clock running. This could be the last play of the game. Garner.
Time's expired. That's it.
The third Saturday in October ends the same way it began. Tied. What a classic.
Unless something happens to Florida State, this tie is big as far as the defending national champions are concerned.
Mutual respect by Gene Stallings and Philip Fulmer. The Chevrolet most valuable players of the game are Charlie Garner of Tennessee, 16 rushes, 126 yards. For Alabama, Jay Barker, 22 of 40 for 312 yards, a career high. Tim, final thoughts.
Well, it was everything we thought it would be, but what a great drive by Alabama at the end. No timeouts left. Barker takes him 80 yards in 123, and then Palmer coming in at quarterback with his play to the corner and the breakdown defensively by Tennessee.
This will be remembered as the definitive play of the 76th edition of the series between Tennessee and Alabama. It ends 17 apiece. For Tim Brandt, I'm Mark Jones. We hope you enjoyed it as much as we did.